Alright, welcome back everybody. Great Pirate Solomon here with you for another episode of Building the Commonwealth. This time we are tackling the enormous Spectacle Island. I have spent some time already cleaning the place up. So most of the trash and structures that we won't be using have been taken away. I've also used a mod called the Rebuilt Series of Homes that rebuilds a lot of the settlements. Rebuilds like the pre-war buildings that were in them, so this once ruined building is now a more or less rebuilt and functional hotel. So this is basically, you know, supposed to be like a seaside resort type thing. This hotel has a number of bedrooms and whatnot. So we're going to be using this enormous settlement for twofold purposes, basically. We're going to use sort of this half of the island for a residential resort area, and the other half of the island is going to be industrial. So let's actually get up on top of the hotel. We can kind of get a little bird's eye view of the area. There's a veranda up there. Alright, so you can see you get some beach property here, you get the barge over there, also the Red Wave is docked over there as well. And then we've got this hill. So basically I'm thinking of like everything in this area, maybe more like a third of the island. Everything up until about where this valley starts here as being part of the residential and resort area. And then the rest of the island all that way is going to be the industrial area. So let's turn on God mode so I can jump off of this thing. What I'm going to be doing in terms of industrial is largely trying to build the solar array, which is sort of the holy grail of the Sim Settlement's advanced industrial. I was thinking about putting it somewhere in this general vicinity. Maybe like here-ish? Or here? You definitely want a bit of flat space around it. Maybe put it here on top of the hill. It's possible I'll have to move it. But yeah, maybe right here would be good. Anyways, let's start plopping down the industrial plots we're gonna need. You're gonna need a bunch of them. The other one's placement won't be as important. This one will be. So, we will start with a foundation. Yeah, I don't know if that's really enough room around it. It's relatively flat. I don't necessarily know that it needs to be super flat, but it seems like that would make the most sense. Maybe do it out here, actually. This might be a perfect spot for it. Get rid of some of these trees. Thank you. Yeah, I think this will work. If not, well. We'll just have to rebuild it. Excavation pits. We want to leave most of this area, you know, kind of wide around this open. So let's go up on the hill and we'll build more of our industry. We are going to need a mine. That's going to be really the first thing we need. And that mine is eventually going to have to become a nuclear facility of some kind.
I've made some friends in the Commonwealth.
So we really want a spot that would look good for the mine as well as a nuclear facility. Maybe right here, going into the hill. So now, like I said, we need two more excavation pits, and we need, I believe, one oil well, and a scrapyard. I think that might be it. Of course, we can't add other things here. We don't have to just have those, but those are what we need. Or the solar array. I want one of these excavation pits to be near one of the highest points of the settlement, which is up here. I believe this is the highest point. Not too close to that, but these trees. But yeah, that should be good. So we're going to have to figure out other power solutions for them. And then let's see. Good spot for the last one. I think maybe more towards the beach area. the last excavation pit. And I feel like I want the oil well to be up in the high area as well. Maybe right here-ish. Still need a scrapyard. Don't forget about that. Scrapyard would probably make sense over by the ship. Theoretically put it out of the water. You say so, boss. I could put it here, or I could put it over by the barge. Even though I said I wanted that to be more towards the residential side of the island, it seems like a good spot for a salvage yard. Scrapyard, whatever. You can put it like right up against the boat. Alright, that's everything that's needed for the solar array. To bring it to its full potential anyways. You can build the solar array with just the iron mine. The iron mine and an excavation pit. The excavation pit is what turns into the solar array, but you need the iron mine to unlock it. But everything else is to unlock its full potential. Thank you. power will be enough to power this in perpetuity, but it'll be enough for now. Now let's see about powering up the rest of them. Should be able to run a line from this one to the other one. Yeah. Maybe. No. Probably use a tree as a connector. This guy, well, I guess we'll keep using trees. Just stick this here in midair. Now let's see what we can do with you. See, there's one there. Right, so we're gonna have to move it a little bit. That's hooked up. Now we've got these two to worry about. There's no trees in between the closest power. Well, maybe get from one of these guys to one of these. Telephone poles. Yeah, okay, that's still too far. And I can always add a tree. And finally, this guy. Might be the hardest one yet. I think we're just gonna have to fudge this one. Alright. There we go. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I think. Stairs. And then we're going to call in some settlers. Settlers, as we said. Yeah, actually the mine is the first thing I want to get up and run.
I'm just so hungry. All the time.
Aideen. That's some name. Well, Aideen, you're gonna start as a lowly iron miner, but you're eventually gonna rise to nuclear physicist.
Okay.
Alright, next. Let's get this one going. Oh, at the very top. That's gonna be one of the longest ones to get to where we needed to. That's not right. Nope. The big boy. How plain.
I'm back hurts, my feet hurt. Everything hurts.
Yeah, I don't think I want you running my solar array. You actually look like a good guy to run the scrapyard. Reagan. All right. I knew I didn't like you. Going to be a nuclear facility. Soak up them rads, lady. That is the problem with this settlement, is it's too goddamn big. Maybe the ghoul is running the mine. No, I have no idea where the goddamn ghoul is.
What's going on?
What do you need?
All right, two more. Just one for the main attraction. Also wondering what's not powered up right now. None of these ones.
Need to get back to Diamond City one of these days. Biggest town I ever saw. Okay.
All right. So there is our industrial base. Now we need to start thinking about residences and whatnot. As of right now, they're probably all going to be using the beds in the hotel. But we need some real homes. Now, let's see. At, when they get to max level, most of these will need two. There's six of them. So I need 12 power between this stretch. Place for a windmill. Generic house. No, I don't think so. Give it a try. Sure, tin can. We'll go for it. Yeah, I guess I'll go with it. I like low tech works a little bit better here. Fisherman's hut is appropriate. place for those long forays into the wilds. I'll say so. I don't think I like it. Let's switch this one to, like, the Mariner's Shack or something. Have nice beachfront property, but it's all relatively low tech, which I feel is kind of appropriate. Maybe the resort workers will have more cramped living spaces and less desirable places, but they will maybe have something a little higher tech. Basically got our industrial base set up. So now we need to think about the other half of the island. So we're going to take a break and we're going to build some stuff and we'll come back and show you what we built. Alright everybody, welcome back once again to our Spectacle Island build. We've come along, we've still got some more work left to do. But let's take a look, see at what we've done. Now, I want the hotel here to be somewhat active, despite, unfortunately, there's no way to like really make a hotel person stand here and rent out rooms. So we are gonna figure out a way to do that, but the best way I can figure out to do it, we're gonna figure out a way to get people moving in and around the hotel, like this person, Dr. Mira, who is a guest of the Sim Towers Hotel, which I built right next to the actual hotel. So I figured this is kind of like the office, and it's got some rooms in it and whatnot, but, we will, that way we'll at least have guests who will be milling about the area. And since it's right next to the the actual hotel, hopefully they'll come in here. I'm going to put a few things inside the hotel at some point. I haven't done that yet. But a couple entertainment plots and some other things to make people actually hang out in here. So it'll at least look like it's being used. But what else we have built? We put a fish farm down here by the water. I also replaced the broken picnic table in here with a working one and stuff on it. Same over here with the patio table. It was all busted up, so I put a new fancy one there.
Best way to deal with the Brotherhood of Steel.
Over here in the old greenhouse, I put in a hydroponics farm. So we're actually using the greenhouse. Over here with a nice little, ocean view near the hotel, I put in a coffee farm. Coffee farm slash coffee shop, so it's get this guy dressed like a hipster running it, which seems, appropriate.
Everything hurts.
Coming down by the water, we're gonna actually build something here, like kind of in this stretch, which I haven't done yet. But here we have the farmer's B&B, so this will be another hotel type thing as well as a restaurant with a nice oceanfront view. I mean, if you don't mind the views of half-sunken shipping containers and whatnot, but, better than nothing. Over here, we already had that. That's the scrapyard thing, but I do have a turret tower up on top of the shipping containers. Trying to keep the Minutemen somewhat unobtrusive. I don't want this place to be crawling with security, so I've only built two security things. And I think I may build one more, I'm not entirely sure yet. But I might just leave it at the two. Over here, this was, obviously a cattle pen of some kind. So I've got a radstag, and I also have a Brahmin and a chicken and a rabbit, though they tend to wander off despite the fact that they're things that they're supposed to stay near or over here. Maybe if I, like, mess with them a little bit. Let's try that. Still seem to tend to wander off for whatever reason. The radstag stays put. I don't know. We did have to build one more industrial plot, and so I built a corresponding house with it. Oh, look, our courier, or our whatever the fuck the name of it is. Supply line, supplier, whatever, provisioner. Made him be flying since he has to go over the water, though I suppose it doesn't really help his Brahmin. I guess we can actually see him. Now, Spectacle Island is one place where it's actually really important to have robot provisioners, because human provisioners will drown coming out here. He might actually go underwater still, despite the fact that he can fly, but whatever. You can, I believe you can use ghouls. Ghouls will make it. Maybe it's not they drown, but get radiation poisoning, I don't know. And maybe that's why ghouls will make it, but if you do send, human provisioners out this way, they will die. So, just a tip. But I did put all of my people working industrial plots in these utility coveralls, so they're kind of matching. I actually put everybody in the settlement in clothes that match their profession. I've got the guy running the fish farm in fisherman's overalls. I've got the guy running the hydroponics farm in farmhand's clothes, etc., etc. But yeah, so I've got an artillery post over here by the water. This is the other scrapyard I had to put in. I realized that I had one other thing I needed to get the get everything proper. So now we've got two scrapyards, three excavation pits, an iron mine, and an oil well, I believe. And the sort of thing that I spent the most time working on since the last time we were recording is this, which is the apartment building that I built for all of the resort workers to live in. Nice tight cramped quarters for the lower class workers on the resort island. So if you come in, you can see there's a community kitchen entertainment plot, and then there's just a narrow hallway, and off of each one is a little interior plot where people live. Six per floor, and there are three floors. So we come up the stairs here, and these ones haven't been built yet. This is a new one I need to stick a wall on. Two new ones I need to stick walls on. And then the top floor is still completely empty, I believe, though I do have a bathroom, community bathroom for the whole place up here. Six more empty splots. I did at least give them a nice, glass roof. But yeah, this took a bit of doing to get all together. Let's stick those walls on. Walled off now. And for this one, we can use not that, that, that. Boom. To fit whatever actual style of apartment is in there. But yeah, so we've got an apartment building. And that is about it. So now we still have probably at least four businesses I want to build, and a couple entertainment plots. And that should more or less round the place out. Maybe another farm, too. But yeah, like I said, I'm going to be building something in this area. It'll actually be like a structure with probably at least two businesses in it. And then I'm going to be putting probably two entertainment plots in the hotel. Yeah, but when we come back, we should have most of the rest of the plots we want to build built, and then we'll go from there. So we will see you then. Guys, welcome back to the end of the Spectacle Island build. It's taken us so long to build this place that stuff's already started to upgrade. But anyways, let's take a little tour. For the things that I have added in this time. See, the motel's gotten bigger, but that's been there. When we come inside the hotel, there is a bar over here now. Doesn't seem to be being manned at the current time, but might be a little too early. Let's sit down and wait a minute. I don't know if I can wait in any of these chairs. They're all pretty tight. Maybe I can.
Another day of hard work. Well, never changes.
I don't know where the bartender is. In any case, there's a bar in here now, and people tend to hang around in here, drinking coffee and eating noodles and smoking and all that kind of good stuff. When we go upstairs, there were two empty rooms originally in this place. One of them is here, and it is now a little smoking lounge. And then over here, we have a coffee shop. Now, when we go outside, you're not one of my people, are you?
Hi.
No, you must be a guest of the hotel.
A It's coming in pretty good.
You can see there's a big glass structure over here now on the beach. You know, to give people views. And inside,
yeah,
there is a bar. Another bar. So this is the rum hole, which, you know, feels like it makes sense here with a nice ocean overlook. I believe it'll be empty. The back wall will be empty at the highest level, so I could be wrong. But we also have a clothing shop over here for the tourists. And then, you know, a little patio area where they can sit and look at the ocean. We've also added in, next to the B&B that was here already, we added in just a general store. You know, something
the
for the
not much, but
people
it's
to shop for rustic goods here on the fishing resort aisle. And then the other thing I felt like we needed in the resort area was a hospital. So this is the hospital up here at the very top.
Not many doctors around these days.
Top of the hill, as hospitals should be built on. And I also added in another farm just to kind of have something over here. Other than that, we also put in a another Minuteman station. This one is a guard kennel, dog kennel. I don't know why this dog is halfway in the dirt,
yes,
but you know, whatever. Other than that, I think that's about all we added in. But if we come back over here to the other side of the island, we can see that some things have changed. Not everything, but some things. We'll see if anything is ready to be upgraded. That is not.
Crop's been growing pretty good lately.
I woke up and the world still...
That
sucks.
Is not.
Today's been great.
That is not. The things that have upgraded already... Oh, I did put something else in. It's over here, but... Things that have upgraded already are this, which this was originally a scrap yard. It is now scrap processing, which gives you rarer scrap than the regular scrap yard. But that will upgrade again at some point. I did put in a water purifier over here. And then of course, this is still the artillery station. Over here, I put in a third bar. This one I sort of envision as being more for the actual residents and not the tourists. So it's over here on the industrial side of the island. And then you can see this, which as you may remember is going to be the site of the actual solar plant that we're working towards. This is now a crystal cavern, which you can actually climb down into. It's a mine full of crystals growing everywhere. Nobody working down here like in the iron mine, but, you know, such as it is. And then the scrapyard on the other side of the island has been upgraded into a crusher as well. I guess we can run over there and take a look at that. Also, the apartment building is now full. I am at my maximum capacity with the amounts of houses I've built. But yeah, here's the crusher. But as to the apartment building, teleported up through the floor. Anywho, so, you know, rooms everywhere here. Second floor is full. third floor is full. And so that is our Spectacle Island build. We will, of course, be upgrading the industry as we go along, but that'll have to happen in-game. This is, you know, as much as I'm going to build here, so it's done. I might at some point start replacing the trees with live ones, but I'm not going to do that now. So, that's about it. Did this just change? I feel like things were set up a little differently a minute ago. But, whatever. Yeah. That is our Spectacle Island, half resort and half... Oh, I put in a lot of light posts out here. Sort of light the touristy areas up at night. I also put some shit up on the balcony. Nothing too fancy, but...
Yeah?
Chase lounge out here, and a easel, and a cooking grill. But yeah, that is our Spectacle Island. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Solomon out. Hey everybody, Great Pirate Solomon here. Just want to thank you guys for watching the latest episode of Building in the Commonwealth. If you like what I'm doing, go ahead and click on my pirate head over there on the right. Subscribe for more. If you want to see what else I get up to on the interwebs, you can follow me on Twitter at GP Solomon. You can like me on Facebook at Misadventures of Solomon. And if you really like what I'm doing, head over to patreon.com/greatpiratesolomon. Throw me a buck or two. If you want to see the last episode in this series, click on the window on the left. Like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.